Hello everyone, and welcome back to Mostly MoonQuest. So, last time we got the combustion engine system up and running for the most part. However, we did have a bit of a mishap with the oil and stuff. So, I fixed that outside of an episode, so now we have oil constantly pumping into them, and then I've got oil constantly pumping out, and I've got a similar thing going on over here. So the combustion engines are running great, all four of them. And using the lots of power that we had, I turned all of this into as much fuel as it can hold. So now, in this episode, we have to get the fuel pumped to these tanks over here, which I don't know how to do. But first off, we're going to need a redstone engine, which I know we're going to have to make, but I really don't want to. Actually, you know what? I'm going to cheat. Well, not really cheat. I'm not doing that. But I am not going to make another one. Because we've got three combustion engines left over, and I really don't want to use them. So, because unfortunately, combustion engines, you have to have the right amount. Because after a while, they just start to become a burden. Because you have to have so much fuel and so much, coolant to keep them sort of under control, and without them then they blow up and they're just causing more problems than they're worth. So for I realize that I haven't really explained combustion engines to all of you guys, for those of you that don't know. Okay, so for Buildcraft there are three types of engines introduced. They're the redstone engines, the Stirling engines, and the combustion engines. Now, they're tiered like everything else. So the redstone engines, as I'm sure you can guess, because we use those the most often, they're pretty much used to do... Oh, wait, I don't want to turn that on. They're pretty much like for pipes. So you see these wooden transport pipes? Those are the ones that... when I use wooden transport or extraction pipes, it tells the game that that is where the stuff is coming out of, not going into. So, and I pump, so, but then also, they aren't just constantly pulling stuff out. I have to turn on a redstone engine to pull them on. But redstone engines, they produce very little power. That's why they're great for pipes. Because pipes don't, pipes just need, you know, they just need some form of power. It doesn't matter how much. But so the that's why the redstone engines are so good, because they're inexpensive. And they don't require any fuel, they just need to be activated by redstone. Now, over here, at the quarry, we've got the Stirling engines. Now, I suppose, I didn't think about this, we could have replaced these with combustion engines, but it would have been a pain to pipe all the coolant and fuel from there over here. Like, honestly, we would have to pump it out of this, we'd have to make more ender tanks, and that would just have been a waste. So I'm going to keep the Stirling engines. Plus, it provides examples, basically. The Stirling engines are the second tier. They're made out of stone, whereas the redstone engines are made out of wood. And these ones use coal as fuel, so it's not exactly... it's not... What's the word? I don't know. I forget what I was going to say. It's not practical. That's the word I was thinking of. Because you have to constantly be getting coal. So, the way we have it set up, it seems like it's working, because we've got stacks and stacks of coal. But generally, Stirling engines are not my favorite, because you have to have them being constantly supplied with coal. Now, combustion engines, they produce the most power, but as I'm sure you've seen, they are the most difficult to maintain. Because, actually, I'm going to... turn these back on because we're running low on coolant. Because they need coolant, otherwise they will explode, and they need fuel, otherwise they will explode. However, they produce a massive amount of power, but they are pretty much the only way to go when you're powering a refinery, because the refinery takes a lot of power to work. Okay, so now we need to go and make another extraction pipe. Which, I guess it's a good thing we have all that pipe sealant. Now, we should only need Should only... Actually, I'm just going to turn all of these into... I'm just going to turn all of these into the fluid pipes. If we need to make more wooden transport pipes, then oh well, but we're not going to need to do it anytime soon. Just because I don't use buildcraft pipes in this very often. I much prefer the mechanism pipes. So I'm just using the buildcraft pipes for this, because this entire area, except for the scaffolding, which is artifice, but everything else is buildcraft. So, generally, I mean, obviously, mods of or items of the same mod tend to work together the best. Now, I believe if we hook it up to the top, it should suck out fuel. I think. And then we can take the stone fluid pipe and run it over literally just like this. And it should go into all of those tanks. So just to top it off, we'll plunk the redstone engine down on top, put the lever. Let's see. Does it work? Yeah, it sucks out the fuel. Yeah, fuel. We have fuel. But I'm not entirely sure if it knows how to go into this ender tank. I don't know how to use the ender tank is the thing, so... Oh, okay, it has to go into the side. So how are we gonna make this look alright? I mean, I suppose it's alright like this, but it just looks weird. But that is all the fuel that we've made. Believe it or not, all of that amounted to that. But this area is something that we're just going to have to turn off and on, because it's very unstable, I suppose is a decent word. So if we turn all these on, then we should be able to turn the combustion engines on. And then that will make more fuel, and it'll just be constantly sucked into there. And we'll fill that all up. Looks good, looks good. And now if we come over here, is there fuel in the bottom? Yes, there is. Not sure what this dial does, though. Alright, so I'm going to break those other pipes for a second. Alright, no, I'm not. I don't want to lose any of the fuel. You know what? We'll just keep making the fuel. Doesn't matter, because I was going to have it just go into the ender tank for now, but I suppose it doesn't really matter. Now, I'm just telling you guys, we've got so many tanks full of oil and so many tanks full of water, but we will probably never fill up these tanks with fuel. Fuel is just so expensive. Like, if you see there, there's just a little tiny layer at the bottom. More of it's in the ender tank than anywhere else. Just it requires a heck of a lot of power to do anything. And I am almost contemplating making more combustion engines just because it takes so long. Alright, you know what? I think I might do that, actually. I'd have to leave for a second, so I'm checking to make sure everything's alright. Yep. Okay, so we can leave for a second. Alright, Blink, you are so loud. Yep, so we've got the fuel going in here. Now what next? We need to make the combustion engines again. Alright, so we're gonna need iron. And first we're gonna need sticks. Now we're gonna have to turn these into the gears again. Piston. And I need a thing of glass. And iron gear, piston, glass, and iron ingots. Great. Combustion engines. Alright, we've got 4 more combustion engines. Perfect. So we can make just a complete another row of them. But we're going to need more wooden kinesis pipes. And maybe more of these as well. Cobblestone kinesis pipes. Alright, looking good, looking good. Nothing blew up, I hope. Nope, doesn't look like it. We're good. Yep, everything's still full on the coolant. What is it? Heat. It's getting pretty hot. Coolant isn't working as best as it could. But we are getting a lot of fuel. But actually, going to turn this all off for a second so I can rewire stuff. Alright, so then we can take the stone fluid pipe and link that up over here. So there we go, that's all hooked up now. Nope, wrong. Gotta hook up the kinesis pipes first, I guess. And nice thing also, the wooden kinesis pipes will not connect to each other. That makes it look nice and neat. And then, good, we can take the coolant, and we'll run that over here. My only concern is that we can't quite reach the levers. So if we needed to turn this system off quickly, I'm not entirely sure we'd be able to. So there, what if we came over like this? Can we reach them all from here? I guess we're gonna have to sort of expand this platform. There. And that'll be my standing platform. And then from here, can we reach all of the levers? Can't quite reach that one on the end. Uh-oh. Okay, what's the best way to go about this? Probably to get rid of those kinesis pipes. No, but we can't do that. I wish just running a redstone signal along would work. But I don't think it does. But that would make this a lot easier because we could just have a lever at the end to turn everything off. Yeah, no, it just turns those two on. All right, we're gonna have to turn these back on so that they're pumping. Oh wait, they are on, or they were on. Are these ones on as well? Okay, good, because we need to have the coolant going to these new ones. Oh, this is troubling. Wait, if we face maybe this orientation, can I reach that one? Yes, I can. Woohoo, I can reach them all. Alright, alright. So, let me just make sure we've got all the fuel and coolant going into these now. No, we don't. Why not? Alright, we've got all this water backed up in the pipes. Why is it not going to those engines down there? That's kind of a concern. Okay, so the first one is full. Guess we kind of just have to wait for them to fill up. Maybe we should make this double-sided so that it can go around like this. Yep, that looks good. And then maybe that'll help it get water. Whoa, what just happened? That was weird. So now let's see if they're getting the coolant they need. That one's full. That one's getting there. That one's not really getting there, and that one's getting there. So yeah, this is working better, it looks like. You know what? I would do that, except for the fact that I'd have to make more redstone engines. Because technically, if you see here, I have them set up so that these two end pipes, and it's the same for the oil, but I have it set up so that the two end pipes are never getting sucked out of. Oh, wow. Okay. So we're just waiting on this one now. But now that the other ones are almost full, all the water seems to pretty much be going to this one. And now, hopefully, we'll refine fuel at lightning speeds. Which, you know, of course we're not going to, just because fuel takes so much power. But it'll be better than what we had. It'll be going doubly as fast. But if you see, I mean, the Ender Tank, we've got it almost half full. It's like a quarter full. So that's not too bad. And that one's just about full, so that one's going to be full. Great, and we're ready to go. Come on, get that lever. This is hard. There we go. Boom, 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 boom. Oh, jeez. Now this thing's gonna be getting so much power, it's like, ah! Yeah, with that exact sound effect as well. Ha 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 ha. Yes, so much power, and I suppose we could always just flick the lever from down here. So much fuel. Yes, refine, refine, refine. Okay, this system of 8 combustion engines is very dangerous. We really have to remember to turn this off, because if I leave this running, we are screwed. So yeah, we are now producing energy doubly as quick. I don't think doubly is a word, but it is now. How are we doing on fuel and coolant and stuff? Doing good. Like, this third one right here is like my gauge of how we're doing, because that one seems to be the one that gets stuff the slowest. Looks like the ender tank's gonna be full any moment now. Oh, what is this monstrosity that we've made? This fuel refining system. But I mean, it sustains itself really well. I mean, if you see, the oil drops, but then it just goes back up. I mean, imagine if we had fuel coming into these combustion engines. That would be insane. Because I think it like doubles how much energy they produce per liter or whatever it measures this stuff in. God, there's so many engines here. There's so many redstone engines and combustion engines pumping at the same time. This is insane. Well, guys, yeah, basically we're just waiting for this ender tank to fill up, because then we can go back over to the, whoops, I fell in the water. Then we can go back and, start making, like, the fuel loader for, the rocket and stuff. And we'll figure out how to make Buildcraft, work with Galacticraft, which will be fun, because Galacticraft doesn't work well with anything other than Galacticraft. So yeah, that's pretty much this episode. Outside of the episode, I'm just going to let this ender tank fill up with fuel. But yeah, I hope you all enjoyed this episode. Please leave a like and subscribe, and I will see you all next time. Goodbye!